Hello and welcome back. This is video 2 out of 5 about classics. I'm gonna do classics this whole week, and I have here another nice wooden box. Well, here we have a closer look, and it says here it is a girls resistant 10,000 ohms MK4, some sort of category. And I already find here a label from MFITNO, and this is the PM5. Now this is added later by the MFITNO company, the one that actually uses it, not the fabricator. And here also, and here it says Medical Psychiatric Department, Health Organization, TNO. So this is used in the medical environment, and yeah, let's open these hooks. It still opens. This one is a little bit stuck. Here we go. Look at this. Okay, that looks very interesting. It's a standard ohms at 60 Fahrenheit. Wild guess, like 20 degrees, I think. I need to find that out. I don't have that technique in my mind. And it is from MFG Co. I did not see that print before. Let's have a look on the internet. Okay, that is interesting. I find several manufacturers, and the box looks exactly the same. I saw it from Griffin and George, and those were around 1930. I have seen it from B Ltd, and even Paya made one. In 1940, and then the MFG, and it doesn't have a year, so I'm guessing it also kind of looks good that it is probably closer to the 40 than the 1930, and it seems to be a whetstone bridge. So it seems to be a whetstone bridge, and you see all these values like 1,000, 100, and 10, and these are actually shorts. So when you take the short out, then you actually add the value that is there. So there are resistance below all these blocks. And if we look at the side here, I will move it a little bit. Here you see X and Galvano. You see here battery and X and battery here. And the battery you can power the bridge or not. And the X is probably the unknown resistor, and then the battery is to power your galvanometer. But then where you add the galvanometer, so that is one side here and one side here. So the meter goes here, the battery goes here, and the unknown resistor goes to X and X right here. Let me draw that in paper. So the whetstone bridge, I think it's usually drawn like this. Resistor. Then you resistor here and resistor here. Here you power it, and here you put your galvanometer. Well, simplified, it is like this. You have here your plus, you have your minus, you have a certain current here, resistor. If they are all balanced, like this is 10, this is 10, this is 10, this is 10, then there will be no current here. So your galvanometer is actually just like a voltage meter, but then with a zero in the middle, you have here a meter, and then it goes to scale to 10, and it goes to scale to minus 10. So then you can see if the current going this way or the current is that way. And that is very nice to measure resistance very precise. And it is just if the balance is the same. So you can also have 100 here and 100 here. And even you can have 1,000 here and 1,000 here, because it doesn't matter. Because if you have 10 volts, then you have, because this is same values, so you have 5 volt here, 5 volt here. So that means you have 5 volt in the middle. If you have 1,000 here and 1,000 here, you have also 5 volts here and 5 volts here. So that means between this point and this point is 5 volts, so it will measure zero because no current will flowing here. So what you can do, you have your, if you want to determine a certain resistor, that is X, well, you saw here on the connectors on the box, you saw X, and then you saw all the pins, that is the variable. So what you try to do, you try to get this in the same balance. And when the current is not flowing, if you know this resistor and you know this resistor, let's say these are fixed 10 ohms, then if your X is 100, then your variable, you just start to change the values, pull and push the pins that we saw until it is in balance. And when it is in balance, you have the same value as your X. So then that is the value of your resistor that you're measuring. So if you want to measure very precise, that is balance is very easy to see, but very difficult to measure, because you can just, instead of putting your X load on this one, you can just put your ohms meter. But if you want to be really, really precise, you use the Wedgestone bridge, because and the meter is in the middle, and when it's slightly out of balance, oh, it will fall. So you will see immediately on the meter also. So it's a nice way, nice principle. Let's open it up. I want to see what is down below in the box. Okay, I'm trying to open it without making too many scratches on the screws. Ooh, very nice. I don't know if they have different sizes. Oh, not much to see for you, I guess. All same size, no problem. Try to lift it. Okay, the screws are removed, but it still looks kind of stuck. So I'm carefully gonna try to pull it. Oh, yeah, it goes. Wow, there is a serial number inside, but no, 8893, with pencil, so apparently they wrote down the serial number in the box, 8893, is that the same serial number that we have here? No, 2893. Well, I'm a bad reader. It says exactly 2893. Wait, but look at this. And let me zoom in, because the back kind of look kind of interesting. Oh, this look like this. But in the back, we have all these resistors. and they are connected to these blocks. Well, I don't see that there, some have been burned, so that is good. So when you pull out here, you see the values, no? You see 100 and 1000, it's a bit dark. But when we pull this one out, then the current flows between these two. And if you put it back, then you short it again. So you should have the lowest resistance when we put all the pins in. So before we start playing, I think I want to try to clean it a bit. Okay, that does look a lot better. I need to try to see the light because it is now so clean that it starts reflecting. But here see all the values. And that you see the values that you can short. Yeah? So this is then the center point that goes to here. And then you have one piece of balance, so the galvanometer. One side of the known resistance you can put in on 10, on 100 or on 1000, and then the same you balance on this side here. Then you have your variable resistor and then you have your X resistance here. So I'm going to put all the pins back and they should have a real good contact now because I clean everything, and then we see how precise the resistance still is. I like it, it's already a lot more shiny than it was. Okay, did I just lose one? No. Okay, let's heat up the kidley and get the... Okay, I have my Kelvins in to do proper measurement. Well, the kidley can just do that instead of the BNC I have with bananas, and it's great. So now, oh yeah, that is zero. Okay, like this I think you can see the kidney and you see the bridge. So well, this is 0 ohms, so I want to put it in the center. And the center is here. And I can also get this one and then see how that goes. Okay, so I think if I get it here and if I get it here, then I have at least this whole string. And well, here we have already 2 ohms resistance, and that actually should of course be zero, but every contact here, all these pins, Because if I take out this one, now I should have 1 ohm. This one is maybe a little bit dirty. Now it's 1.8. Now it's stuck. Now it's maybe a little bit oxidized. So I need to clean all these a little bit better. Now we have 2 ohms. Yeah, and then it goes to 4, so this one seems to be okay. This is 3 ohms. Yeah, this is really the problem of the oxidation. Now it's 3. Yeah, it adds 10, so that works. It adds 30, and yes. It adds 40. Ah, now it's low. It adds 100. Look, now we are here. So if you go back now to the one. Okay, we're slowly getting there. Now it needs to go back to 0. Yeah, they're all a little bit oxidized. 300. This is just really a break. Three thousand. Now we're already below 0.5 ohm. So this is really just a contact problem in all these pins. It's just oxidized in all those years. So it's just need to. Okay, so they still work. At 1 ohm, yes. Let's see the other side of the bridge. Yeah, this one goes through a pin here, so this one is 1,110. So if I go here, but then I need to push the button. No, it's 700 ohms. How good is this switch? This is really 0. Now we are here in the cross point. This is the center, this is the center, but this is dirty. But this one is really. So now I should have it at 1,000. Yeah. At 100. At 10. At 10. 100 at 1,000. Look at this. This is a precision instrument when it is clean. Wow. Now I also have the long strip. I also have below. Wow, so when all the contacts are clean, the resistors are actually quite good. But I need to do a little bit more cleaning, but if we have a good look, it is already very nice. Look at this. Wow, wow, wow. The resistor looks very, very nice. And because sometimes you use a bridge to low, very low frequencies, but resistance. But this one is actually made to do higher because it can go up to 10,000 ohms. So it's probably used for those strength strips, strength gauges, or those are of higher resistance. As you see, the scratches are a little bit less. I was able to carefully get that out. Slide polish. So the box also looks a lot better already. So that is it for today, but we have 3 more days left. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time.